In this video, we're going to quickly derive the first derivative of the inverse cosine function, and then we're going to apply it to a simple example that incorporates the chain rule. So whenever you're dealing with an inverse function, it's wise to give it a name. So I'm going to call this y equals the inverse cosine x. And then the whole motivation for this is that this allows you to turn it around in terms of an ordinary cosine. So I have y equals the inverse cosine of x. We could read that the angle whose cosine is x. So when I turn it around, I get the cosine of y is equal to x. What we're going for here is dy dx, and we can get this to pop out by taking the x derivative of both sides. In calculus one, that's usually called implicit differentiation, but that's really just the chain rule. So I have on the left-hand side the cosine of y, but y is a function of x. So to differentiate that with respect to x, I first differentiate with respect to y, and I get a negative sine y. But because y was a function of x, I then have to tack on the derivative of y with respect to x. On the right-hand side, I have the first derivative of x, which is just 1. Now our goal here is to solve for dy dx. Because y is the inverse cosine of x, dy dx is the thing we're looking for, the first derivative. And I end up with a negative 1 over the sine of y. Now we're not done yet, because what we want is a formula for the first derivative of the inverse cosine entirely in terms of x. So I need to take my definition of y and substitute it back into this expression. So I have dy dx is negative 1 over the sine of y, but y is the angle whose cosine is x. So in that denominator, I have the sine of the angle whose cosine is x. Anytime you have a trig function of an inverse trig function, you can express it in algebraic form. The way we get it done is by visualizing the angle whose cosine is x in a right triangle. So I'm going to label that angle right here. That's the angle whose cosine is x. Another name for that is y, the way we originally defined y. And so that's the angle whose cosine is x. That means the adjacent over the hypotenuse must be equal to x. So we can make the adjacent side x and the hypotenuse 1. This allows us to determine the opposite side, which is important because we need the sine of this angle. So we can guess and check to make the Pythagorean theorem work out. I need to be able to take x squared plus something squared and get 1. So I have the square root of something ready to go. And I think if I make this the square root of 1 minus x squared, that should do the trick. You can verify it by squaring the adjacent side, adding it to the square of the opposite side, which just undoes the square root. We see the x squareds cancel, and I get 1, which is the same as 1 squared. So now I want the sine of this angle, the sine of the angle whose cosine is x. And that's the opposite over the hypotenuse. The hypotenuse is just 1, so I'm not even going to write division by 1. I just have the square root of 1 minus x squared. We go back to our derivative. I have dy dx is equal to negative 1 over the sine of the angle whose cosine is x, which we just figured out is 1 minus x squared square rooted. And there's our formula for the derivative of the inverse cosine function. We're going to wrap things up by applying our new formula to the inverse cosine of pi x, and this is going to require the chain rule. So the argument of the inverse cosine function there is a non-trivial function of x. I need to apply the chain rule, and the way this goes is that I first differentiate the inverse cosine with respect to pi x, in other words, treating pi x like it's just a single variable. So we apply our new formula. I get negative 1 over the square root of 1 minus the argument of the cosine function all squared, so that's pi x all squared. Then the chain rule says I have to multiply by the derivative of pi x, and that's just pi. Cleaning things up a little, I can write it as negative pi divided by the square root of 1 minus pi squared x squared. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. Or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.